The incident occurred off Cape Hatteras in the United States and involved northbound traffic which follows a northerly course after passing the Diamond Shoals light. The incident occurred during the day, in conditions of good visibility and moderate weather. Vessel T was heading on a course of 000 degrees at a speed of 17 knots. Vessel C was heading on a course of 010 degrees at a speed of 19 knots, passing across the stern of vessel T. At a time of 20 minutes before collision, C-20, ship T observed C on its own starboard beam and overtaking. Ship T had changed to manual steering, while ship C was still on autopilot. At a time of 10 minutes before collision, C-10, ship C changed her course to 000 degrees to come on a parallel course to ship T. At a time of 6 minutes before collision, C-6, ship C was 0.75 nautical miles ahead of ship T when the master of ship C left the bridge. Meanwhile, the officer of the watch on ship T went onto the port bridge wing to take a bearing of the Diamond Shoals light facing astern and left only the helmsman in the wheelhouse. At a time of 4 minutes before collision, C-4, ship C developed a failure in her steering system and the ship turned hard to port. At a time of 3 minutes before collision, C-3, ship C was ahead of ship T on a crossing course of 270 degrees, when the officer of the watch sounded the whistle and ordered the engines to stop. The officer of the watch on ship T now sees the developing situation, sounds the whistle, and orders harder port and stop on the engines. Ship T strikes the port side of ship C at an angle of about 90 degrees. Both vessels sustain damages, but there is no loss of life. In your opinion, which vessel violated which rule? Click on the buttons for a quick overview of the relevant rules. Rule 5. Rule extract from Rule 5. Lookout. Every vessel shall at all times maintain a proper lookout by sight and hearing, as well as by all available means appropriate in the prevailing circumstances and conditions, so as to make a full appraisal of the situation and of the risk of collision. Rule 15. Crossing situation. Type your answer in the space below. Click. Extract from Rule 6. Safe speed. Every vessel shall at all times proceed at a safe speed, so that she can take proper and effective action to avoid collision and be stopped within a distance appropriate to the prevailing circumstances and conditions. Extract from Rule 13. Overtaking. A. Notwithstanding anything contained in the rules of Part B, Sections 1 and 2, any vessel overtaking any other shall keep out of the way of the vessel being overtaken. B. A vessel shall be deemed to be overtaking when coming up with another vessel from a direction more than 22.5 degrees above her beam, that is, in such a position with reference to the vessel she is overtaking that at night she would be able to see only the stern light of the vessel, but neither of her side lights. D. Any subsequent alteration of the bearing between the two vessels shall not make the overtaking vessel a crossing vessel within the meaning of these rules, or relieve her of the duty of keeping clear of the overtaken vessel until she is finally passed and clear. Extract from Rule 15. Crossing Situation. When two power-driven vessels are crossing so as to involve risk of collision, the vessel which has the other on her starboard side shall keep out of the way, and shall, if the circumstances of the case admit, avoid crossing ahead of the other vessel. Overtaking ship C was held 82.5% of the blame when failure of her electrical steering mechanism caused her to swing to port across the bow of the vessel and into a collision with the vessel just overtaken, ship T. The officer of the watch was deemed negligent for the following reasons: failing to attempt to steer manually in violation of the bridge standing order, delaying the sounding of any danger whistle signal, and failing to stop engines as soon as possible. The overtaken vessel, T, was also 17.5% at fault for the collision, for failure to maintain a proper lookout with respect to ship C still close off her starboard bow. On the facts, the last clear chance doctrine was inapplicable, even assuming that it survives the Supreme Court's reliable transfer rule of comparative fault. When the shipowner, petitioning for limitation, cannot explain why its vessel's steering failed and must exhaust all possible causes and prove its lack of privity and knowledge as to each, this burden was not sustained, since the shipowner, chargeable with knowledge of a potentially serious problem in the electrical circuits, failed to employ qualified experts to determine the cause.